glad we found the scroll, but I wish she could come with us. The sooner we get the scroll home, the sooner we deal with my father. I'm glad we found the scroll, but I wish she could come with us.
All right. Hello and welcome back to Vingroth's War Mage Adventures in Skyrim. Let me just fix this. That's better. All right. Gosh, Serana. I realize we're leaving your mother again and, you know, the Soul Karen. But friggin' deal with it and stop saying it every 2 seconds. Oh my gosh. I need to download that mod that shuts them up. Because holy shit. Anywho, last time. We went in the Soul Karen, and we upgraded all of our armor, which was awesome. Actually, we upgraded armor first. And we've upgraded our armor so much so that the highest costing destruction spells we have look like they're 5 mana. That's pretty amazing, Saberwolf. Yeah, I love when that happens, when you kill something in the water and all of a sudden they start floating down the river. It's really... And then you're like, maybe I should fix that? Is that a good thing or not? Hey, Convoy, how's it going? But yeah, so last time we're in the Soul... Oh, no, never mind. The most expensive is Tempest Cloak. But as you can see, we've lessened the cost of destruction spells. Hey, terrible impersonator, how's it going? But yeah, so we've gotten some crazy stuff. Oh gosh, Sable. But yeah, so we're in the Soul Karen. We've actually met Dunavir, I think that's his name, which is the undead dragon that guards this place. Could you really, Serana? I'm gonna have to like actually keep moving so that she can stop talking to me. Holy crap. But anyway, we've been through the Soul Karen. There's just a few more things that we have to do in the Soul Karen before we leave, and one of them is getting Aravak's skull. Which we did get, but I need to hand it in to the original owner. And we also need to look up all the pages of Jub's opus. Hey Lord Never, how's it going? Ooh, cool, awesome. Oh, that'd be amazing, Connor. Holy crap. So I think we're heading towards it right now, aren't we? Miscellaneous, return Arvex skull. Yeah, there we go. I think. Unless this is taking me back to... Let me just check for a second here. Nope, okay, it is this way. Excellent. Oops, that's the wrong button completely. We also want Impatience of a Saint, which is Jub's thing. I know, free Dragonbone weapons. I know, we got, yeah, we fought the Keepers, and we got... Let's see, we got a Dragonbone Battle Axe, which is badass as hell. Like, out of the... There's very few Dragonbone weapons I actually like the look of. The Dragonbone Axe looks fantastic. We got a Dragonbone Longbow, which for some reason isn't showing up. The Dragonbone Mace is alright. Can we please take a look at the... weird. Yeah, the bow looks alright.
Who's there?
Oh gosh, is there something? There's something here. Holy crap. But yeah, so we got Dragonbone weapons, which is awesome. I mean, I can actually craft Dragonbone at this point, which is awesome as well. But that's pretty cool. Although I think when it comes down to it, most of... Do they do more damage than Daedric items? Really? I might have to create... because I have enough to make... like a whole dragon set. I'm gonna have to see if that's a thing. The only problem is the Dragonbone hammer looks so dumb. It's literally just a femur. It's literally just some like dragon femur on a stick. It looks terrible. That's my only problem, is that I'd much rather take, you know, the Daedric Warhammer over a friggin' Dragonbone femur. What are you gonna do?
Arvak! You saved him! His soul is free, I can feel it! He's such a loyal beast. Here, I'll teach you how to call him to you.
He'll help you get around this wretched place. But I'm sure he'd be much happier someplace sunnier.
Sweet.
Goodbye, hero. Take good care of Arvak for me.
Oh, with all of the fancy upgrades. Well, we could possibly upgrade the dragon weapon, see if it's worth it. We'll take a look then. Once I get out of the Soul Cairn. Because that's something I haven't really considered, is what is better, dragon or Daedric? I always thought Daedric was better, but that could have been like a personal bias I used to have. I still have. So we now have a spell that can summon Arvak, who's a freaking awesome friggin' horse. In fact, I'm gonna put that on. Here we are. And this is vanilla, by the way, just to let you know. Arvak is freaking awesome. Come, Arvak! He makes the, like, bone sounds when he walks. But he is so friggin' cool. Now, I believe I actually have a spell somewhere, and I don't remember where. Daedric just looks amazing, that's right. Ah, really? Dragonbone weapons do more damage. Interesting. Now, I remember there being there was some crazy spell I learned, and I don't remember what it was. Alright, maybe I don't even have it, but I was reading somewhere that there, or either something. But, like, it allows you to have your mounts run faster for a little while. I think it might have been a scroll, actually. Alright, now, we could spend forever and an eternity trying to look for the dude's pages, so I actually have found a little, like, picture of it, so I just need to, for some reason it's not, no, there we go, I want that. Wow, for some reason my stuff's really acting up. That's really weird. Alright, I'm just gonna have to go like this for a while. Alright, so what pages are we missing right now from Jub's Opus? Oh, here, right? So we have one. So we don't have two. No, for some reason my Firefox tabs just won't work at all. It was kind of weird. Two. Ah, yes, I know where two is. Alright, Arvak, let's go. I really like the Dragonborn DLC, personally, yeah. It's amazing. Actually, I can go here and see the full map. Alright, so I think we want to go over this way. It's fine, terrible impersonator. I frequently comment on how bad my own spelling and grammar is, and that it's actually so bad that I understand basically all bad grammar and spelling because of it. Alright, I think this is one of the places we need to go. Let's get off Arvak. Did I break my keyboard somehow? Yep. Okay, save wolf. Yeah, my keyboard's, like, really fucked right now. I don't know why this happens, but for some reason, like, and then I can, like, sort of move my mouse. So yeah, I hate when that happens. Basically, for some reason, the W key is stuck, and I'm pretty sure that if I tried to alt-tab it into somewhere else, it would just constantly... No, W doesn't even appear, which is fun. I don't know why this happens, but it's always happened with this keyboard. I gotta plug and unplug it. Okay then. Then my whole keyboard doesn't work. That's fun too. My mouse works at least. Oh, wait. Wait. Oh. Hey, there we go. I was very worried there for a second. That my whole keyboard went weird. All right. Oh, this is a destroyed word wall, looks like. Ah, yes. Excellent. Just need two more pieces. Pieces? Pages? Pieces of a...
I'm glad we found this.
Oh, gosh. Wait, I can't...
You could come with us. I'm glad we found the scroll.
It seems that her scripting has gone into full effect, and for some reason I can't access her inventory as if she were a companion. But I do actually have a spell that we learned called Deep Storage. And it's... Isn't it an expert level? It's an expert level alteration spell.
Come on, let's go home.
And... It opens up deep storage, which is essentially infinite storage, which is fantastic. So, I won't be over-encumbered. Yay! I still wanna... I need to... If anything else, I need to find the quest to get rid of these two things out of my inventory. Because it annoys me. Ridiculously. Oh, that's interesting. I also need to find out why I can't drop the ruby and sapphire dragon claws. That's, like, really annoying. Let's put these away. And that should do for the time being. Awesome. That helps. Yeah, I know what you mean. Terrible impersonator, yeah. I think, again, I fall to, like, personal, like, nostalgia bias with the Dragonborn DLC, because one of my favorite areas was Solstheim in Morrowind. And so when, you know, Dragonborn came out, I was like, no, what are you talking about? They brought it back? Holy crap. It's like one of the few times, like, within the past, I don't know. It's just one of those things where they're returning to something older, and I'm like, holy crap, I was actually a part of that. Granted, I guess if you played Arena, or, you know, some of the older Elder Scrolls games, you'd be returning to some of the same stuff again. But at least in my gaming career, that's the only time that that sort of happened. Anywho. Let's see, we've got one, we've got two, three... I think we're missing 4 and 9. Oh, which are all sort of around the same area. Alright, all along this edge bit. Alright, we got it from here. Let me just get this out of the way and make sure everything's good to go. There. Awesome. And we get summon Arvak. What the hell's Arvak? Summon Arvak. It's a shame Serana doesn't have a horse. Could I teach her summon Arvak? Something I haven't considered. Alright, have we been here? Ah, we haven't been here yet. I remember this place. This place is pretty cool. Oh. Although, oh yeah, last time, I don't know if you were here for this. But, if you weren't, because our destruction spells are so, like, they don't cost much at all. They're so cheap to cast now. We've actually changed our spell twine. And so... I don't think it shows up in the magic menu. No, it doesn't. But, for instance, I have on this, it has an ability called Nova. It does 40% of the damage that my total alteration's worth, or something like that, which is pretty cool. And, my area of effect spell actually heals me, which is awesome. It heals me for, I think it's 50% of what my alteration stuff is. Yeah, yeah. Yeah, it's pretty wild. Yeah, pretty wild tale of impersonator, yeah. Let me check something out here. What I want to check out here? I think I want to. Yeah, so as you can see, I can just sort of go like this, and it heals me, which is awesome. Alright, I was going to check what my alteration skill was. Also, it's probably not a good idea, in case this is one of those, Opus, Jubb's Opus areas. Because that wouldn't be good. But as you can see, it heals me for 50% of my alteration skill, which is getting up there. My alteration is 78. So that's pretty nice. That's pretty nice. So as opposed to actually using a healing spell, I'll just use my destruction spells. Or any spell entwined. It doesn't have to be destruction. I do have to do a quick look around here just in case. We did look in that area, which is fun. We head out the back here. Whoop. Still check if there isn't anything stuck anywhere. Have we been in? I think we've been in there. I may or may not have lost my bearings. Let's see. There. Maybe it's over there. That was the second one. We're looking for 9. Page number 9. Grab soul husks too, because I'm gonna try to get a really nice. Spellbook from the guy who sells. Well, he doesn't really sell things, he trades for soul husks. So we've totally been in this maze before. Did I just miss the page here? I might have. If only there was a levitate or jump spell. That'd be great. Actually, what is it? If we do the... Oh yeah, there was that one enemy in here I couldn't find, so maybe we just didn't take the right turn when we went in here. It is a bit of a maze. Here. Sorry, I was like covered in electricity for a little bit there. We looked through there. Why is there a mannequin here? That's really weird and disturbing. Yeah, I don't like that. I don't like that at all. Alright, well, let me just double check this thing. So I do want to get these pages before we head out. Let's see. There we go. Probably some sort of glitch. It's pretty weird. Pretty weird indeed. Alright, let me see. Okay, so... Let me take a look at the map again. Yeah, it should be in here, page 9. The issue... Ah, here it is. I just didn't take a look at that side, apparently. Lol. It's kind of like under the thing, and I'm always a little bit worried because I use that, like, explosive spell. That, and I can also use this explosive spell. Which, that explosive spell does, like, damage based on the percentage of people's health. Which is pretty damn wild, because I fought like a dragon, and it really effed him up bad. It was pretty cool. And we have found all the summons, I believe. What does this mean? That's interesting. Staff of Chain Lightning, Dragon Priest Dagger. Hey! Get out of here, Mr. Man. Actually, where'd he go? Where's he go? Oh. I think he fell. I think he exploded. I'm not sure what happened there. Huh. Well, that's interesting. I'm pretty sure I caused some things to explode. Which I didn't want to have happen, but there you go. How does one get down from here, like, in the vanilla game? Oh. Here, I guess? That's an interesting little spot there. Huh. How about that? Yeah, because I think we've been there. Is there? Yeah, there's people down here. Holy crap. Oh, I was using an explosive spell. I forgot I switched back. Or I didn't switch back, rather. But you can see how this can be a problem. I mean, it's freaking amazing, but at the same time. The fact that it can screw things up so royally is an issue. There should be like a way that you can set so explosive spells, I don't know, magically have no way to move physical objects, but yeah. Alright, so I need to go like up northways a bit. Think. I have to find out where the Soul Cairn is, base, or where that one area is in the Soul Cairn where we fight the dragon. It's a weird area, and it's very difficult to sort of navigate it because all the buildings sort of have the same color, and although they don't look the same, it's very easy to be like, all right, I've been there, and I'll go this way. And, like, sure, there is a compass, like, north, south, east, and west, but then you see the wall and you're like, where the hell am I? Alright, so we need to go, like, somewhere over there. Alright, let me get Arvac back. Come here, Arvac. I don't know what that is, terrible impersonator, but that sounds interesting. We have to head this way. I feel like I would actually move faster with loot magnet, actually. Whoa! Someone's shooting at me. That was me summoning again. Take that. Yeah, I think long stride is actually better for movement speed. Oh, okay. I haven't actually seen that movie. Yeah, using the spell might be as fast as using a horse. Not sure though. They move pretty damn fast. It basically, it multiplies your speed and also gives you, yeah, I think I might move faster than my horse doing this. I think so. Alright, so I think the last page of the Opus is over here. Because we haven't, I don't think we've been to this building yet. That's how it works, Saberwolf. Yep. In Skyrim, you just leave a trail of naked dead wizards. It's true, though. It's so true. Oh, hey! Silver ore. Oh, gosh. There's a mistman coming to life right next to me. And Opus's... Jub's page just went missing. It was on the floor. Uh-oh. So it was like right there. I think I might have to toggle collision to get it. Cause I don't see a spot where like it flew off. Either that or it really did fly. Like really far. Let me see. Or it fell? It was like right there. So it either fell. Which would be a little bit awkward. Oh, it's right under the pile of bones. Which I don't think I would have been able to get normally. Yep, there it is. I have to... There it is! That's really awful. That's really awful. Alrighty. I hate when that happens. Because you can't walk through those bones, you walk on top of them. Yep. Friggin' A. Alright, but we found all of them, which means we can return to, Jub. Actually, let's read the whole thing, shall we? Because we have all the pages now. Alright, let's start with one. I am a hunter, a redeemer. I am Jub. The tale of my rise to glory begins in the ash wastes of Morrowind. I rode alone, weapon at my side, and the burning wind stinging my face. My quest was arduous, but necessary, to ensure the survival of Dunmer people. The pestilence was creeping across the Ashlands. It wasn't there originally, Terrible Impersonator. It was under the chest, and then somehow through fighting this guy, it had moved under that bone pile. So it wasn't there originally. I moved it by using destruction spells. So, unfortunately, it clipped through that and got stuck. A menace with an insatiable hunger that plagued innocent travelers simply trying to get home. It was my self-sworn task to hunt them down one by one and drive them from the skies. Their fury knew no bounds, and their war cry resonated across the land. They were the notorious Cliff Racers, and they had to be destroyed. On a particularly hot day during sun's height, I was... Oops. Thanks a lot, Lightning Magic. Yeah, I don't know how. I was using single target magic, too. I wasn't even anyone. Tracking what I called a lingerer, a cliff racer without a nest. He was a particularly feisty one, too, leading me to on a merry chase across almost 3 miles of ash dunes. I managed to take a piece out of one of his wings in an earlier scuffle, so he couldn't maintain much of a climb. But he had quite a bit of stamina left. And he was trying to make me tire the chase. Almost 2 hours passed, and my silt strider, was tiring. He had his own Silt Strider? That's friggin' cool. But I couldn't give up. I had sworn to eliminate the foul beast from the land, and I wasn't about to let it go. If I was going to stop the thing, I had to do it fast. I pulled my longbow from my back, notched my last arrow. I took a deep breath and pulled, trying to keep the Cliff Racer in my sights. It was literally a long shot, with the beast gaining distance. And the Silt Strider bouncing me around at full gallop. You don't actually see, like, Silt Striders in motion. Silt Striders are pretty cool. Finally, with a silent prayer, I released the string. The arrow sang through the air like a howling demon as it sliced its way towards its target. Finally, it had just crested the lip of a Foyada, which is like a lava. It's like a lava channel. It's weird. Morrowind's just a crazy volcanic island, basically. Let's see. Yes, the arrow struck it in the midsection. It let a horrible cry and fell at us up. My cries of triumph were... Silt Striders, I know, right? There's one in Dragonborn, actually. Quickly stifled by the sound of 100 wings, rising from the Foyada was an entire colony of Cliff Racers, and they were out for blood. The blasted thing had led me right to its nest and sacrificed itself with the innocent feeding, with the intent of feeding me to its brood. It was a trap. The damn things had become much too clever. Knowing this was likely to be the end, I jumped down from the Silt Strider and hit the back of his legs with the flat of my glass blade. He had a glass blade too, that's cool. There was no need for the innocent thing to die here because of my stupidity. As the ash cloud cleared from being stirred up by its massive legs, the Cliff Racer brood approached. I held my sword high and prepared for the worst. The battle lasted 2 full days. I was beaten, clawed, bitten, and knocked down more times than I care to. Remember, in the end, 76 Cliff Racers were slaughtered. I was knee-deep in their corpses and my body on the verge of collapse, but I'd survived. I smiled to the heavens, and all went black. When I awoke, I felt my back was on a cold stone floor. Every muscle in my body was on fire, and my vision was blurred. Slowly, I tried to climb to my feet. It took several agonizing minutes, but I finally managed to do it. As my eyes adjusted to the dim light in my new surroundings, I realized I was standing before Lord Vivek himself. Hey, convoy. Let's see. He was simply staring at me, floating above his throne and staring at me with his piercing eyes. When I began to prostrate myself as a sign of respect, he held up one of his hands as if to say it wasn't necessary. Was I dead? Was Lord Vivek pleased with me? Was he? Nice call. About to strike me down in anger for my somewhat sordid past, suddenly I understood everything. Suddenly I realized I was brought here for a reason. I should have died in those ash wastes, but Lord Vivek must have seen something inside me that he hadn't seen in millennia, and decided to spare me from my fate. Thus began my ascent to sainthood. Thus began the rise of Jub. So there you go. Jub. Now, the thing of Jub is it, and if you know, if you played Morrowind, Cliff Racers were an annoying pain in the ass. And they could follow you for a very long time. And their draw distance was incredible. So, just walking across some of the Foyadas in Morrowind would maybe get about 5 or 6 on you if you were, you know, unlucky. So, they could be pesky. And especially, like, if you're coming out of a dungeon. oh gosh, convoy. But yeah, so, and they were especially annoying because after, like, a huge dungeon, like, you'd come out and there'd be a Cliff Racer right friggin' there attacking you. Which, depending on your health, could be devastating. But what's interesting is, I don't know if it's an immersive creatures thing, but I have actually seen Cliff Racers in Skyrim. So, I'm a little, like, I don't know if he, like, the 67 were the last 6, or the 76 were the last 76 Cliff Racers in existence, or if it's just like, he killed so many Cliff Racers, he's a hero. sort of thing. But it could be that immersive creatures just added back the Cliff Racer. I don't know.
You did it. You have all of my pages.
Here's all the pages. Hey, George.
Finally, I never thought I'd see these again. These pages mean the world to me. Thank you.
So what now?
Now volume 2 begins. What else?
I'll be off then.
Oh, wait a moment. Here, I want you to have these before you go. A pristine copy of my first volume. Only one in...
Oh, Immersive Creatures added them? Okay.
And take this as well. Seeing as Saint Jib has ascended to pure spiritual form, I won't need it any longer.
The sooner we get the scroll home...
So, technically... Oh, really? Interesting. So Immersive Creatures added, like, the flying ones. And they were in vanilla, and you couldn't interact with them, and they were static and passive. Interesting. Huh. Now, interestingly enough, Jub's... Locket of Saint Jub is one of the few amulets that actually have armor rating to them, which is kind of awesome. It gives you armor rating, and plus it gives you increased carry capacity and stamina. Unfortunately, I can't wear it at the same time as my War Mage amulet, which makes my destruction spells cost less and gives me another thing. So, unfortunately, I can't wear it. But if you were to maximize armor for possibly a like a playthrough where you didn't wear armor, the Amulet of Saint Jub and the what is it called? The circlet of... what is it called? It's not the circlet of the savant, but it's that thing that you get from Shalador's maze. They're like the two clothing items that technically count, or don't count against mage armor, which is awesome. Alright, so we can actually head out of here then. I believe. Right? Now... Of course, I say we can head out of here, but at the same time, I have no idea where I'm going. So, let's see here. I think we've done everything now. That doesn't seem right either. I have to find the big wall. Nope, I need long stride. Because long stride makes me move faster than horse does. Which I didn't even think would be possible. Okay, so I think we need to go this way. Okay, gotcha. Sweet. I like that we get a horse, but one of my spells actually makes me move faster than a horse does. Ah, yes, we have to talk to this guy. Now, what we're gonna do is we're gonna save here. Oh, you are a convoy? All right. I'll see you later. Have a good one. I'm going to save here and see if I can't ask this guy for...
What do you want?
Let's see. I want a spell tome and see what he gives me.
Sure. Here you go. Can't understand a word of it. Maybe it will do you some good.
I know Tempest Cloak. But yeah, we could totally like spam this and just keep doing this to this guy until he gives us like a really good spell tome. See, now here's an issue. I might want to get rid of this, actually. But I have Great Infusion, which is cool and all, except every time I log in, it gives me, like, the Dragon Sigil armor and the Dragon Sigil weapon. So I'm just going to drop them every time.
Brought some... Well, I've been so busy, I don't know.
Oh, do you? Okay, George Birchie, I'll see you later. I understand, it's exam time. Alright, spell tome?
Sure, here you go. Can't understand a word of it. Maybe it will do you some...
Or a Cryomancer Sight. What is that? Toggleable aura that chills nearby targets, keeping it up reduces the maximum. That's pretty damn cool. is pretty damn cool. What I'm going to do is we're going to load. What I'm thinking is that maybe because we have gardens active, we could just harvest. Oh gosh. We could just harvest this stuff over and over and over again. If we really wanted to, we could just come down here and buy him out of like everything. Because basically it just takes from a random loot table, which is pretty awesome. Because you can get some pretty sick stuff. Although it is completely random, which also is not the best, but still. Are we under attack? We are. For some reason, Bonemen can't be paralyzed, which is kind of weird. No, not lightning room, lobster. Right? Gotta love that 3x movement speed. Alright, then we're done in the Soul Cairn. Sweet. And at some point we need to figure out why I can't talk to Serana. Or at least access my inventory through Serana as a companion.
As soon as we get the scroll home, I'm glad we found the scroll, but I wish she could come with us.
Yeah, unfortunately that's not gonna happen. Or at least not until we progress further in the quest line. Let's head back.
I'm glad we found the scroll, but I wish she could come with us.
Serana? You're doing that thing again when you're naked?
What now?
Okay, good. I forget how I fixed this. I can make her open her backpack so that I can actually take everything. Which I will do now, only because I'm afraid bad things are going to happen. I think it's time for us to part ways.
Good luck out there. Hopefully I'll see you again soon.
I think then we find her again. And then hopefully she's wearing the armor. I think that's how I did it in the past, was you have to dismiss her and then get her back. But let me activate deep storage so that I have the stuff stored away. There we go. Friggin' deep storage, though. How friggin' neat. Okay. Put those away and these. Anything in here that I want to... Oh yeah, probably about 10,000 gold. There you go, that's better. Alright, so... Is there a, Where is she gonna go at? She's probably gonna go in the first room, so I'm just gonna go out this way. See if we can't meet her around the other side of the castle. Oh yeah, I have to train up my, my vampire stuff as well, because we have some like really sick vampire perks that we can get. One of them even involves flying, which sounds amazing. So I'm definitely gonna save. And let me activate the main quest again. Bring both Elder Scrolls to Dexian. Okay. Oh yeah, and then at some point we want to check out Dragon weapons versus Daedric weapons. Because I think I can use a battle axe, technically. Vanilla-wise, Skyrim basically takes weapons into six categories. They first split off into light, or what is it? One-handed or two-handed weapons is how it splits it first. And then once it's there, it's either axe, mace, or sword for both two-handed and one-handed. But in this, what it does is they call it heavy and light weaponry. And instead of just, you know, hammers, axes, and swords, they have blunt weapons, slashing weapons, bladed weapons, or piercing weapons. and I've been told that axes are technically blunt weapons in this mod pack, so I could technically use a dragon battle axe. You'll see why I'm a bit weird about this when you take a look at the dragon warhammer. It's terrible. It looks awful.
Yes, how may I serve you, my lord?
Oh my gosh, that's awesome. Jason81, how's it going? Alright, I've brought the Elder Scroll.
I'm afraid I won't be able to help you with the scrolls any longer, my lord. Please, do not be angry with me.
Okay, what are you talking about?
I'm afraid in my haste to read the first scroll, I neglected the time I needed to prepare. The failure is purely mine to bear. As you can see from my bandages, it's not that I am unwilling. It's that I am physically unable.
You're blind.
Oh, please, my lord. Please, forgive me.
I don't suppose there's a cure?
If only such a miracle existed, I'd overcome the impossible in order to secure it, if it meant pleasing you.
Okay. Then I have no further need of you. Wow, when you do the vampire thing, you become a straight-up asshole.
Although I would gladly die by your hand, perhaps I could offer an alternative way to read the scrolls.
Go on.
Oh, thank you, my lord. Thank you.
Just get... Wow, you really... You can't be like a nice vampire. Like, you have to be an asshole. Just get to it.
Across Tamriel are secluded locations known only as Ancestor Glades. There's one in Skyrim in the Pine Forest. Performing the ritual of the Ancestor Moth within the glade should provide the answers you seek.
Explain this ritual.
It involves carefully removing the bark from a canticle tree, which will in turn attract ancestor moths to you. Once enough of the moths are following, they'll provide you with the second sight needed to decipher the scrolls.
Carefully gather the bark, how?
In keeping with tradition, you must use a specific tool in the ancestor glade, an implement known as a draw knife. Every moth priest is taught this ritual, but few ever get the chance to perform it. You should consider yourself fortunate if it works for you.
Do I need to read the scrolls in any particular order?
From what I saw in the vision, the Elder Scroll which foreshadows the defiance of the gods with the blood of mortals is the key to the prophecy.
Okay. What went wrong?
Deciphering one of the Elder Scrolls is nothing like reading a simple book. There is quite a bit of ritual and concentration required. It can take months or even years to complete a single scroll, and even then, months to recover. Fortune smile upon you, my lord.
Alright, so I have to... As you can see, Serana's naked. She just decided to unequip all of her clothing. So we're gonna save. And I'm going to... I guess quit to desktop? Would work. And then I have to see if... Dismissing her and restarting the game basically makes the game go, oh yeah, remember all that equipment that you have on you? You should probably wear it, right? Right? let's hope that works. Otherwise, she's gonna be naked the whole time? Which, you know, is alright, I guess, but... Hey, you're back!
Do you need something?
You know, I'm gonna keep her as just a normal follower for right now. She's wearing all this stuff, I'm not gonna go crazy right now. So we can trade a...
Oh, you're off on your own for a while?
Nope, nope, right. Nope, that's not what I meant.
What now?
Come with me.
I knew you'd miss me.
Huh, okay, so... We have her equipped anyway. We're just gonna, like, sort of keep her as a normal follower, and instead I'll use deep storage. Because it's kind of weird. Okay. It's kind of weird because she is very much scripted into coming with you in these quests. So I'd rather just keep her as a normal vanilla follower and not have any mods sort of activated with her. Although she is equipped with full dragon scale armor and a warforged Daedric war axe, so I think we're good. Plus she's got modded spells as well. So let's see how this works out. I've got gosh, I have so many locations. They actually talk about where I needed to go. Find a Moth Priest's knife. I feel like I almost went to the Ancestor Glade once ahead of time. Yeah, Ancestor Glade, yeah, awesome. I felt like I found it at one point. I'm like, we're gonna need this location later. Don't remember why I was up here. Probably dragon stuff? Probably dragon stuff. Oh, let's make sure I got the right spells equipped here. Alright, let's check this out.
Not very impressive, is it? If this ends up being a wasted trip, your friend Dexian and I are gonna have some words when we get back.
Are you really gonna argue with a blind man? Like, that's not cool. Alright. There we go, that's better. Sweet.
Wow. Look at this place. No one's been here in centuries. I doubt there's any other place like it in Skyrim. It's beautiful.
Yeah, it's pretty damn cool. Alright, so we need to find a draw knife and get ancestor moths to follow us. Oh, well, there's one right there floating in a shrine.
Now all we need to do is track down one of those canticle trees.
Canticle bark.
Hope the moth like that bark as much as Dexian said they would.
So I have to attract a moth swarm.
They've definitely taken a liking to
you. Oh yeah, look, I got butterflies or moths.
You're starting to glimmer.
Am I starting to glimmer? Huh. Alright, let's find another one of these trees. I'm starting to gather moths. There's some more moths. I just need to find one of these trees. I wonder if there's like a secret word wall or something. There's gotta be secrets in here, right? It'd be weird if there wasn't. Isn't this another one? Another tree? I walked like straight through that branch. Oh yeah. That's some freaking quality right there. Oh yeah. See right into that limb. Oh boy. Oh, do I just... Oh, is it now that I just attract... I don't have to get bark anymore. Ah, I just need to get moths now, I think. Right. Oh, good. We got another swarm of moths. Excellent. Let's get some more moths. They're very interested in the bark. Sweet. Nice. Apparently, oh gosh, she wasn't kidding about me glowing, actually. Whoa, I've got like a sphere around me. That's crazy. Alright, and 7. Holy crap. Wow, okay. Go to the Column of Light and read the Blood Elder Scroll. Okay. Let's do this then. Elder Scroll Blood. I think it's making a map, actually. Something. Yeah, mark card. And something. I don't know what that wolf is. Is that, Solitude? Huh. Alright, let's speak to Serana. That was nuts.
Are you okay? Almost thought I lost you there. You went as white as the snow.
Don't worry, I'm fine.
I never trusted those damn scrolls. Who knows what those things could have done to you? Just look at Dex again. What about Ariel's bow? Do you know where we can find it?
It's in a place called Darkfall Cave, because apparently I know where everything is.
Then it's almost over. We can finally rewrite the prophecy as we see fit. Where is this Darkfall Cave?
The scroll gave me its exact location.
Then let's get going. I want to get there before my father has a chance to track us down.
Sweet. Did you have something else to say? Oh, okay. Alright, let's head out then. Okay, Oh great, it's Dawnguard. Guy's dead, I'm pretty sure. I think they have an armor control as well. Armor and swamp troll. These guys have anything good on them, or is it just pretty much the same stuff? I'll take the steel bolts, just in case. Which I really don't need the steel bolts either, technically, if we're not even going to do crossbows for this. I'm feeling that next playthrough we're definitely going to be using a crossbow. And probably illusion magic as well. I'll take that. Oh yeah, we should check around here for any secrets. Just gonna look, oh, nice. Glass shield of dwindling magic. Yeah, I feel like checking the corners of this area is probably a good idea before we leave. Just for any little hidden things. It looked like a bull, not a troll. Yeah, they're pretty wild. They're pretty wild. Especially when they're all armored up and stuff. I'm not sure. Is there more? There's a couple other caves that are... These interior caves always mess me up because they look very similar to each other sometimes. And I know there's one where there's like some old giant chest somewhere. I might be thinking of a different one. What is up here though? Oh, there's Helmet of Constitution and a ruby. Okay. So got a few little, like, hidden things of loot in this area. I'm up for that. I like it when games reward people that are thorough enough to check little corners like that. It's always fun. Alright, I think that's about it for this area, unless there's something under the waterfall. Actually, as much as that is like a trope of video games, I think I've only seen something behind a waterfall once in this game. What dungeon is that? I can't remember what dungeon, but there's like a waterfall and behind it there's usually a sword of some variety. And at later levels it could be like a glass sword or something like that. Okay, he's pretty nasty. So the Dawnguard got here, though. It says a lot about them, actually, to go that far. Oh yeah, my vampire blood's probably acting up. Where's Serana? Okay, so... Darkfall Cave. Alright, before we go there, I'm gonna stop by the house for a second. I wanna see if I can't plant Soul Husk and try to make some dragon bone weapons. Let's see if they're any better, because apparently dragon bone weapons are better than Daedric weapons. Oops, didn't mean to take the diamond, but whatever. Oh, do I need more than... I probably need leather strips, and don't I? Yeah, probably.
It's so bright out.
Do-do-do-do-do, leather strips.
Here, I don't know how you stand it.
Alright, so... No, apparently I need a lot more than that. What do I need? Do I need ebony? You do need ebony, in fact, to make dragon bone stuff. I did not realize that. Weird. Where's the ebony at? I should have a decent amount, because I bought a lot off of some merchants. Alright, cool. So, when I said that I was yeah. So this is what a Dragonbone Warhammer looks like. Hey, Slushy Master, how's it going? Which is why you can see that I'm not very like, oh man, Dragonbone Warhammer, that'd be amazing. Oh, no. No, it really wouldn't. It looks... You're hitting someone with a femur. Like... Let's be honest, it kind of looks like a ball sack. Like... Yeah, it's not cool, man. It's basically... You're just basically holding a giant dragon donger. Whacking people with it. Which is why if you gotta go with any two-handed weapon, I think you gotta go with, a Dragonbone Battle Axe. Which... I think it is the same damage, technically. Let's see if we can't reforge a Dragonbone Battle Axe. Oh gosh, Slushy Master, that's pretty nuts. Let me grab the stuff in deep storage. Yeah, it's basically a giant dragon dildo. A giant bone-hard dragon dildo. Hey Zerpy, good. We just read the Elder Scroll, the Blood Elder Scroll, and we're going to head over to Deepfall Cave to get Oriole's bow. But before we do that, I've been told that Dragonbone weapons are actually more powerful than Daedric weapons, and I was going to see if that's a thing. Now, unfortunately, I've kind of gone over the fact that Dragonbone Warhammers look awful. I hate their design, like, tremendously. But the Dragonbone Battle Axe is nice and is basically the same exact damage. So we're probably gonna go ahead and see if we can upgrade a, yeah, there we go. Reforged Dragonbone Battle Axe. And a Warforged Dragonborn Battle Axe. Dragonbone. Nice. You use swords? Swords, yeah, the swords are nice. See, I always, like, a sword like that looks awesome to me. There's so many swords that look normal to me. I know, right? Slushy Master, exactly. I don't want that to happen. Where I walk up and hit some guy and it's like, did you just hit me with a giant dragon dildo? No. Let me see here. I need the notched pickaxe for this. And this is a Warforged Dragonbone Battle Axe. Now, how does that compare? Not as good as Daedric. Not as good as Daedric. Wow. Huh. I mean, it comes close, but it's just not quite there. Huh. How about that? Oh well. It's good to know that stuff now, that, you know, we have a more powerful Warhammer on us. It does seem a bit weird at the same time, but, you know, I'm not gonna, like, say no to it. Got some bark. I remember that you can't put away the draw knife for some reason. Should I make the dragon dildo hammer? I don't feel like it. I don't feel like having a dragon dildo hammer. But maybe it'd be something. Alright, fine. I'll make the dragon dildo hammer. A warforged dragon dildo hammer. Alright, let's do this. Dragon bone. Oh, I need ebony. Damn it. I keep forgetting. Does it look better when you hold it? Okay. Alright, let me see. Dragon Warhammer. Okay. Warforged or reforged dragon bone Warhammer. And now a Warforged dragon bone Warhammer. Okay, let's see. Warforged Dragonbone Warhammer. Yep. Yep. That's... Mm-hmm. I realized what they were going for, that they were going for, it's like the natural, like, you're literally just taking the bones of a dragon and, you know, making them better. But at the same time, like, come on, man. Can't you do something cooler for a Warhammer? Like, who was the guy that was just like, alright, what looks more blunt, like, the bluntest blunt weapon on a friggin' dragon skeleton? They're like, the femur! And they're like, alright, why don't we just stick a femur on a haft and call it a Warhammer? It just looks like I have a dragon penis on my back. It's just, no. Thank goodness it doesn't actually do more damage than my Daedric Warhammer. Friggin' A. I will hang it up, though. I will hang it up. On full display for everybody to see. I will keep those. Keep that. I'll keep that, too. I think we have a second one of those. I have most of those already. Probably sell those. I'll keep that. That's cool, too. I think we have one of those. Oops, I want that. Shield, that, these, and that. And how much gold do I- oh gosh, I have a lot of crap on me, I forgot. Where'd my gold go? I had gold on me, didn't I? Didn't I have gold on me? Does Serana have all my gold?
Oh, what is it?
I think Serana has... Does she have my gold? Honestly, it doesn't matter. That's what a crazy amount of gold that's already in there. I think I lost probably about 10,000 gold or something like that. Maybe. Alright, is that everything? Did I put the gold in here? I did. Okay, never mind. I thought I lost it in like deep storage or something. Alright, sweet. And then let's put our dragon... dragon penis on display. Why? Alright. Dragon penis. Might as well put this up here too. Sweet. That one actually looks okay. Let's see. And the gold is what's weighing me down right now. Hilariously. But you know, I guess you don't actually, what? Yeah, I don't actually know what the weight of a gold coin would be, and then carrying 10,000 of them would be pretty ridiculous. There we go.
The twilight watches us all.
Let's see, and I want to put away, oh, I could probably sell that. Alright, I think we're good to go. I put away most of the things I want to anyway. Oh wait, I want to see if I can plant the that crazy stuff that I have on me. The soul husks. Nope, soul husk is technically a food.
Honored to see you.
It's
again,
a bit of a shame.
By the gods, I know this looks bad.
All right, how much do I have on me then? I have 149 soul husks.
Let me explain.
Oh yeah, so I don't know if you guys were here for some of this, but Ilya basically went hostile after I sacrificed a whole bunch of people during the 24-hour attempt that I did on maybe 2 weeks ago. Hey, Bakor, how's it going? We read the Blood Elder Scroll. We dropped off a few things, made some Dragonbone weapons. And, yeah. So we're heading over to try to get Oriole's bow. Alright. But yeah, basically, Ilya went insane one day. And, yeah. She kinda... Well, I just sort of, like, reset the mod. But it also reset her stuff, so she was a companion at some point, and now it's reset it to, like, the part where you see her in Darklight Tower after she murders someone, which starts her whole quest. So, I'm kind of curious what would happen if I sort of talked to her again and be like, oh hey, how about this quest where you killed somebody? I wonder if she'd, like, try to walk us all the way back to Darklight Tower. It'd be interesting. Darkfall Cave. Hell yeah. It's very dark in this cave. Holy crap. Thank goodness my hands illuminate. Huh. Can I do a thing here? Oh, summon Dunavir? Sweet.
What? Nakas!
I don't know if you're supposed to do that. Well, I mean, they wouldn't have made the whirlwind sprint shout if they didn't expect you to do that, right? Ah, so you come out of here later then, don't you? Okay. Good to know. Good to know. Let's make sure that our powers are set to something a little bit better. I'm gonna try to go Vampire Lord, actually. See if I can handle it. My vampire is at a low level right now, so I might find that it'd be better for me to not be a Vampire Lord. Okay, let's crash. That's always a fine way to start off that. Maybe it's like you're not supposed to be there, which would be interesting. Alrighty. Are you fucking kidding me? It was a long ass time ago. That's a Vampire Lord. Although, unfortunately, that's taken us back to when we saved to try to get Serana back.
What now?
Which I have to friggin'. It was causing crashes before, but now that it's rearing its ugly head again, I need to change this. Autosave manager, save events. It's gonna have to be on travel, because holy crap, I can't have that happen again. I guess we're not gonna craft that stuff this time because we know it's a waste of time. So I'll just drop everything off. Actually, I don't know if we have to. Yeah, I don't think we have to. Because I have deep storage now. Yeah, we're fine. We'll just go. But yeah, the Vampire Lord's pretty cool. It's like the pure bloodline of the Dragonborn DLC. Which is awesome. It also gives you like a whole bunch of new powers and you float around. You normally can't loot anything, just if, like, as if you were a werewolf. You don't have that capability, which is beyond me, which is why I have a mod that makes it so I can still loot in vampire mode. Which is fantastic, because in vampire mode you technically don't have carry weight issues, which is kind of awesome. So I think I might actually change right now then. And I'll feed on the lifeblood of this goat!
Who's there?
But as you can see, I'm having trouble with wolves. So, you know, that's a problem. Come back here, goat!
That'll yes.
But yeah, so I've actually added a mod that makes it so that the vampire tree actually extends much further than it normally would, which is awesome. So normally it just does, like, up to poison talons. All the rest of that stuff, actually, maybe even Nightcloak. Yeah, I think Nightcloak is part of it. And then the royal bloodline, all of this is new stuff, which is awesome. And in fact, at some point you can get evolved wings, which sounds awesome, basically enabling me to fly around. It's true, Slushy Master, it's very true. You can stay a vampire lord for however long you want to. You know, except sometimes it gets a little weird when you're going to a city and you're a vampire lord. Wait, really, Bakor? Serana weakens vampire lords? That's a thing? I didn't know that. Like, as like a statistical, like, number? Like, she actually weakens them? Make her unfollow and you'll be more powerful. Huh.
Who's there?
I think she has to follow me for this quest. But you can see how difficult it is for me to kill this as a vampire lord. Like, Serana's doing most of the damage there. And in fact, I didn't even get the kill there. Which is unfortunate. So this place might not actually be viable for the Vampire Lord right now. That's weird. Why is that a thing?
Things aren't right. Be careful. I think we may be in for some trouble.
Oh, it didn't let me mind the moon.
Help me reach Ancestor Blade soon.
Really, as long as Serana is your follower, you deal next to no damage as a vampire lord. Oh gosh! Wow, I didn't realize that. I thought I was just a really weak vampire, but here, since Serana's been with us the whole time, why is that oh gosh, there's a lot of spiders. Is it supposed to be like a, oh gosh, that really hurt me. It's a glitch in the game, really? Really? So it's a weird glitch in the game that Serana actually makes you weaker. That is so weird. You'd think one of my follower patches would try to fix that. But no. Apparently not. Wait, how can I be poisoned? Aren't I a vampire? Or is that diseases? It might be the disease engine, not poisons. That is a really weird glitch. And that thing just became a thing. Really interesting. Lore-wise, yeah, I guess she has a daughter, Cole Harder. But yeah, it is kind of weird, though, that they would have that glitch in there, and that it's still active despite all the mods that I've added. Yeah, because this is taking a while. I mean, I'll take care of all these spiders just because it'll give me some extra blood. That's friggin' crazy. There's gotta be a mod that fixes that, right? I might have to add that. There are a lot of spiders here, though. Oh my gosh, this takes forever, though! Holy crap! Okay, I'm not becoming a vampire anymore. Vert form. Oh, thanks for the follow. Give me a second. Aliens QC. Thank you. Steam currency? That's a thing. That's weird though. I'm gonna make a little note of that. Serana makes vampire lords weaker bug. Alright, I'm gonna have to try and fix that later. Because I definitely want to be a vampire lord. It seems amazing. The only reason I'd go against it. Oh, stream currency. Oh, you mean like the whole betting thing? Maybe. Oh gosh. I think I paralyzed it. There we go. I still don't think it's dead, actually. For some reason, my animations go off like a little bit before they should. It's a little bit weird. Oh, hey, there's a chest back here. I meant to look at it. The chest. No, the chest. There we go. Barbarian hero circlet. Sure, I'll take it home. Actually, it's really funny. So, is Serana actually not necessary to bring along in all these quests? Because I always thought she was, but maybe she isn't. Yeah. I've seen that in other channels. That might be interesting to do. It's really dark. Alright, so that's where we came from. So head up this way. Is that fire resistance? Oh, heck yeah, I need that. Take spider eggs. Oh man, because I sheathed it again, I don't have the light. I'm gonna grab a small light here, actually. Let's see, candlelight. There we go. Couldn't see crap there. Ooh, that's a door. I like that you can see those ahead of time, like if they're not hidden well enough. I mean, like old-fashioned D&D, there used to be like knock spells and it would like blast open doors that you knew existed. What do we have here? I think that takes you to the spider. Okay. Okay, so that's a shortcut to get back up. Interesting. So, let's see then. I guess we'll come across that at some other point then. Alright, glowing mushrooms. Take one anyway. Why they have spider eggs is a bit odd. Friends. Darkfall cave note. Ooh, let's see that. Okay. Sister, I know that you'll come find me, but it will be too late. If you find this letter, get out of this forsaken cave as soon as possible. We were fools to think we could live so close to such creatures and live peacefully. I should have headed back to the camp after we placed torches down here. I thought these trolls would be different, that would somehow understand that we didn't want to hurt them. I am now cornered, and it's only a matter of time before the troll decides to finish me off. I hope it's a quick death. Farewell, my dear sister. Huh. So they tried to live in that cave, and that didn't work out too well for them. And apparently there's a whole bunch of trolls down here. Great. Just great. What's up here? Interesting that they have a little loop there.
Keep your eyes open here.
Yeah, I was just getting that feeling. We're definitely not alone. Oh gosh, so you're really making use of those illusion spells, Sabriel. Nice. Yep, there's one. I'm gonna try to sneak attack it. I like that I get sneak attack damage. Normally that's not a thing. At least for spells. You're level 12 and your illusion is 45. Holy crap. Are you using the courage spell over and over and over again on your companions? Because that's one way to get your illusion spell up easily. Or your illusion skill. Probably someone that they were eating. But yeah, courage. I might not have it. No, you repeatedly used calm on a cow. That works too. That works too. But that was only a level 30. Okay. Yeah, there's a spell called courage, and it basically boosts the health and stamina of a friendly companion. So if you have a companion with you, you can use courage on them over and over and over again. It's a really easy way to level up your illusion. Although I have to say, if you're going to use illusion, sometimes having a companion's not the best thing, because they're like, oh, I have such high aggression. I see that guy through that wall over there. And then you're like, whoa, wait, we were going to take this nice and calm and I'm attacking now. And then you're like, oh crap, I was going to like calm everybody down and maybe make them fight each other. Nope. I wish Bethesda really worked on the fact that companions can see through walls and like weird crap like that. That, you know, shouldn't happen. Oh crap, damn, this freaking cave is dark. Nice, Airborne, nice. Yeah, yeah, I've been looking at the Fallout 4 posts. Yeah, yeah. They basically have in-game their own sort of mod configuration specifically for consoles, yeah, which is awesome. And hey, the Pagan. A decent stealth mechanic. Yeah, yeah. Some that's not too crazy either, because there's some that are just mental. Alteration's your favorite? because of telekinesis. Interesting. I'm really liking Alteration right now because they've added so many new things to Alteration through the Apocalypse spell package. For instance, deep storage. Access to an infinite underground storage space. Hooray. You're going to get all the radio mods? Awesome. Drop zone, the thing that allows me to not die and take fall damage as long as I cast it in the right place. I also have one called Find Ore. I've also got Long Stride, which is one of my favorites. While concentrating, I move 27% faster and gain carry weight, which is awesome. So there's a bunch of friggin' crazy things I can do with Alteration now. This is backwards, isn't it? This is backwards. Damn it. Really easy to be turned around this place. Alright, now where do I... Okay, I have to go this way. Gotcha. Oh. Okay, then. Oh, troll. Fall New Vegas, the music would be amazing. I love that stuff. Whoa! Hello, troll. Activate Shrine of Oriole. I think we have to do something here. Let's see. Are there any mods I recommend? Actually, I'm not sure, Airborne. I think I might still have my list of Fallout 4 mods below the description, and they're all pretty damn good. The only thing is, I'm probably going to have like a whole new list made up, because I think I'm going to start my Fallout 4 third playthrough for the Far Harbor DLC, or at least preparing for it, next week. What if I cast a spell? Apparently that didn't work. Wait, what? Wait, what? We're not that far back, are we? No, we can't. What? But wait, what? But we... Okay. So, remember when the game crashed on me and we lost time? Apparently... Apparently I never actually did the quest to get to this point. Which is why it's not letting me go any farther, because technically I haven't read the Blood Scroll yet. Stride and get the hell out of here then. But yeah, I'm basically, probably this weekend, I'm going to be sort of compiling a new list for Fallout 4. That doesn't seem right. Let's see. Isn't there a... I thought we found like a... Yeah, I fucked up. I screwed up pretty bad there. This way. Oh, shit. Can't see freaking crap in this darkness. Yep. this way. Alrighty then. Friggin' A. So. I knew that this was here, but that never actually stopped me from, actually, I want to see, is there anything down here? Nope. There needs to be more rewards for water exploration. That's all I'm saying. Alright. So, now we gotta go back to the Ancestor's Glade, because technically we weren't supposed to find Darkfall Cave yet. I mean, it's always been there, but we can't actually progress any further because we haven't found the draw knife and done all that cool stuff. I'll just try to do it quickly. I have a lightning spell and long stride active, so I should be moving a lot faster than normal. We'll just friggin' speed through here. Oops, I need to go across the log. It's also Rana's fault.
Your friend Dexie and I are gonna have some words when we get back.
All of this is Serana's fault. If Serana didn't just decide to suddenly be naked, then I wouldn't have had to restart my game and start all this nonsense. Well, I mean, actually the restart had nothing to do with the crash, but whatever. Speed running. Well, technically it's not speed running because I'm using non-vanilla assets, but whatevs. Draw that knife, collect the moths. Moth collection time! Collect those moths, 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 moths. Get the moths, do 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 do. Do 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 do. Getting all the moths, do 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 do. Give me your moths. Stuck on thing. You can't jump when you're casting that spell, unfortunately. Collect all moths. And we just need two more swarms. And bam. And bam. Hooray! And then read the scroll. Read the scroll. Nope, that's not the right scroll. Blood! There you go! Hooray! Oops. Speak to Serana. Do, where are you? I left you in a cave up there because I friggin' went nuts. Can't handle how fast I move. What?
Where'd you come from?
Why is there a. That's a little awkward. There's nothing a good, good ol' this'll solve. Why was there a gate here? I don't remember this gate happening before. I'm just gonna slip on through. I think that guy's dead. I think someone down here is still alive. You're alive! There we go. Not anymore. Alrighty then. Wow, Serrani, you took a beating there. Holy shit.
Are you okay? Almost thought I lost you there. You went as white as the snow.
Don't worry, I'm fine.
I never trusted those damn scrolls. Who knows what those things could have done to you? Just look at Dex again. What about Ariel's bow? Do you know where we can find it?
It's in a place called Darkfall Cave. You know, the place we were at 2 seconds ago, because I apparently had some weird prophetic dream about it.
Where is this Darkfall Cave?
We were just
in it. Then let's get going. I want to get there before my father has a chance to track us down.
Oh, so that's awkward. So I needed to talk to her in order to have that go down. I maybe would have been able to... No, you can't talk to her during combat. Yeah, so, yeah, we had to do that. Alright then. Then we'll head back down. Friggin' A. Oh, Darkfall Cave. So we'll put on Longstride and Thunderbolt. I'll move faster because I have lightning spells equipped and also casting Longstride. Okay. Interesting, Saberwolf. That's a tough choice there. I'd say probably 10% chance to crit with archery is probably the way to go. And then next level you should probably go along with harder to detect while sneaking. Yeah, I think that's how you should do that. I mean, it's up to you, but that's my opinion. Basically, adding any ability to crit is amazing. It's probably one of the coolest things that happens. Longstride is such a friggin' amazing spell. Yeah. So now there's a guy here as opposed to just having nothing be here.
Come forward. You have nothing to fear. I am Knight Paladin Gelibor. Welcome to the Great Chantry of Auriel.
This cave is a temple to Auriel?
Auriel, Auriel, Alkosh, Akatosh, so many different names for the Sovereign of the Snow Elves.
I guess so, Saberwolf. It depends on how sneaky you are. Snow Elves, you're a Falmer?
I prefer Snow Elf. The name Falmer usually holds a negative meaning to most travelers. Those twisted creatures you call Falmer, I call the Betrayed.
I don't know, Airborne. I feel like if they are working on the Elder Scrolls 6, we're not going to hear, but I don't think we're going to hear about it anytime soon. I still think a lot of their resources are being used on Fallout 4. Although, it'd be interesting for them to be like, okay, so we're just gonna pull this one out of our ass. And hopefully it's not ass. I imagine, you know why we're here.
Of course. You're here for Auriel's bow. Why else would you be here? I can help you get it, but first, I must have your assistance.
How do you know, actually?
For the thousands of years I've served as the Chantry's Sentinel, there hasn't been a single visitor here for any other reason. They request Auriel's bow, and I request their assistance. It's been repeated so many times, I can't imagine it any other way.
What type of assistance do you need?
I need you to kill Archcurate Werther, my brother.
Kill your brother? Why?
The kinship between us is gone. I don't understand what he's become, but he's no longer the brother I once knew. It was the betrayed. They did something to him. I just don't know why Auriel would allow this to happen.
What exactly did the betrayed do? When he says the betrayed, he means the Falmer, the one that you see, like, with the Dwemer, and they're all, like, sort of, like, blind and stuff.
They swept into the Chantry without warning, and began killing everyone without pause.
Didn't you fight back?
The Chantry was a place of peaceful worship. I led a small group of paladins, but we were no match for the betrayed's sheer numbers. They slaughtered everyone, and stormed the inner sanctum, where I believe they corrupted Werther.
You don't even know if he's alive?
He's alive. I've seen him, but something's wrong. He never looks as though he's in pain or under duress. He just stands there and watches, as though waiting.
Have you tried getting into the inner sanctum?
Leaving the way shrines unguarded would be violating my sacred duty as a Knight Paladin of Auriel, and an assault on the betrayed guarding the inner sanctum would only end with my death.
Okay, way shrine?
Yes, let me show you.
Oh, thanks for the follow, Chubbs2424. Thank you. Alrighty.
So this is snow magic. Incredible.
It's pretty cool.
This structure is known as a way shrine. They were used for meditation and for transport when the Chantry was a place of enlightenment. Prelates of these shrines were charged with teaching the mantras of Auriel to our initiates.
What's that basin in the center signify?
Once the initiate completed his mantras, he'd dip a ceremonial ewer in the basin at the way shrine center and proceed to the next way shrine.
So these initiates had to lug around a heavy pitcher of water. Marvelous. How long would they have to do that?
Well, once the initiate's enlightenment was complete, he'd bring the ewer to the Chantry's inner sanctum. Pouring the contents of the ewer into the sacred basin of the sanctum would allow him to enter for an audience with the Archcurate himself.
All that just to end up dumping it out? It makes no sense to me.
It's symbolic. I don't expect you to understand.
So, let's get this straight. We need to do all that nonsense to get into the temple so we can kill your brother and claim Auriel's bone.
I know how it all sounds. But if there was another way, I'd have done it long ago. The only way to get to my brother is by following in the initiate's footsteps and traveling from way shrine to way shrine, just as they did. The first lay at the end of Darkfall Passage, a cavern that represents the absence of enlightenment.
Okay. How many more way shrines are there?
There are 5 in total, spread far apart across the Chantry.
These caves must be massive.
Caves? Oh no. The Chantry encompasses far more than a few caves. As you'll soon discover. But before I send you on your way, you'll need the initiate's ewer.
Alright, so I need to fill this at each way shrine.
Once you've located a way shrine, there'll be a spectral prelate tending to it. They will allow you to draw the waters from the shrine's basin as if you've been enlightened.
Okay, I'll be off then.
This may be the last time we're able to converse. If you have any questions before you leave, I suggest you ask them. Otherwise, all I can do now is grant you my hopes for a safe journey.
Alright, survive Darkfall Passage! Alright then, I guess there's nothing I fill up here, so we just go to the portal to Darkfall Passage then. Let's do this! Dun, dun, dun,
dun, dun, dun. That wasn't as unpleasant as I thought it would be. Kind of soothing, actually. I feel a little warmer now.
That's some like undersea crap right there. Awesome. And that would be a Charis Hunter. Hey, Jason W. Let's go. No problem, no problem. I understand. We just made it into, is it Blackfall something or other? Yeah, Darkfall Passage. We found these weird little things, and of course there's Charis fledglings flying around, and there's weird glowing cracks. Oh, Falmer! The bad kind. Hardened Falmer armor. Take those.
Who's there?
Take that too. There's someone else down here as well. Charis as well. Is that thing still alive? It is still alive. Holy crap. Now he's dead. Oh, now there's a skeleton attacking me? Oh, okay. We have Falmer bandages, circlets. I'll take the void salts in that. Continue. This place is pretty awesome. Oh gosh. I think, did she trip her own trap? There we go. She might not actually be dead. I have played Borderlands 2, yeah. I haven't played it on stream though, but it's a good game. I really like Borderlands 2. I'll probably have to at some point. See if that thing's alive or not. Sometimes it's weird. My mouse like locks up for some reason. Okay, so that one wasn't active. There's a little way this way. I wonder what this is. Oh, it's a loop around. There's a lot of weird loop arounds that I guess if you were a sneaky character you could end up using. But I'm pretty much straightforward, just walking in, blundering. No, I don't really do song and quest stuff. Mostly because I upload everything to YouTube, and as it is, sometimes it catches in-game music and gives me copyright infringements. So, I can't imagine what would happen if I had actual songs going on. A couple more things here. I don't want them to jump up if they're active. Alright, I think we're good so far. I know.
I knew I heard something.
We'll probably have something at some point where we can do song requests, but yeah. Basically, YouTube and sometimes Twitch is very much, you know, like, oh, we detect a song, and then it's like, well, you can never do anything with this video. Actually, that's not true. I don't monetize anything, so technically, that's fine.
Where'd you come from?
Fledgling here too. The fledglings do not fall over as if they were paralyzed. Kind of tough to hit. Take a Falmer ear. Ah, Gleam Blossom. Sweet. We definitely want to take as much of that as we can. Even though I don't technically do alchemy. nice! Saberwolf, did you add some mods? Because that's not a vanilla thing. That's not vanilla, actually. Normally you get the 5 gold from Riften for killing a chicken and it stays there. I'd be scared like shitless if a Charis this big went at you. Nice! Turret kid. Nice.
Where'd you come from?
Oh gosh. That dude came out of nowhere. Armor gear. I'm just wondering if there isn't a thing on the wall. Really? Oh yeah, I remember that. Because for some reason, animals can actually see you do crimes and it counts. Which is a weird, weird thing. But yeah, that is an actual thing that animals can essentially report your crimes or something like that because they're technically a witness. It's weird. Yeah, I'm not sure how you spell it either. It's fine. Yeah, if I saw, like, a Charis that big, like, crawling at you, that I would not be happy. Looks like she resurrected a skeleton. Take the green blossom. And that was a trap. Yeah, I'd run. I'd definitely run from that. Serana's doing work over here, though, while I'm just effing around over there. Okay, they've done some interesting stuff. Oh, there's more Falmer. You're still fighting this person? I swore I taught her better spells at some point. Oh my goodness. Night Prowler. Falmer Club. Oh, that's interesting. Oh, goodness. Is that a free emote, by the way? It's too funny. Take the moon blossom and all that. I think Falmer ears are used for poison, so I always collect them. Take those gleam blossoms. Yeah, it is cool. Lol. Okay. Falmer Nightmonger. Then I shot him again for good measure. Nice. Alright. Nothing like a good ice spike to the ass.
Oh my.
Alright. I do want to check something, actually. We have spell twines active, which basically add extra effects to our spells. And I think one of them might not actually be doing anything. So, right now we have... let me just check something. Our alteration skill... The frick, I've gone in a complete circle. Alteration is 78, and it looks like it's like right under the A. I'm gonna cast a whole bunch of destruction spells and see if that doesn't change. Actually, I'm gonna go for one that I know works. How am I hurting so much? Or did I knock her back and she got hurt? Oh, hey. The hell? Serana? The hell? Well, let's just see if that actually leveled me up at all. Not really, no. Weird. Maybe it takes a longer time. I wonder why Serana suddenly got aggravated by my spells. She's technically a follower, so technically I shouldn't be doing damage to her because I have that weird black book active. That's okay. We'll just load from before I tried to test that. That's weird. That's really weird. Oh, stop giving me the dragon sigil thing. I've got to stop that. It freaking gave me two. Holy crap. Get out of my inventory. Alright, then let's continue. And not try to do crazy things. I don't know, maybe. Oh, let's see. I took those gleam blooms. Interesting. Okay, I'll take that. Some flames. Let's go ahead here. Is it two ways? Oh, I totally saw that guy before he came out of there because he's a, thing. What does the illusion spell do? Yeah. Profession of curiosity. Let me see what it does. I think it's a, it's an illusion skill, but it's from a mod. Target temporarily loses 15%, health per second while under the while the caster concentrates. Interesting. Huh. I'd like to see what it looks like. Cuz that's got to be interesting, right? And there's one in there too.
Who's there?
Oh, destruction increase, that's the important part. Let me see here. I don't really have many illusion spells. Just give me a second while I try to cast it. Oh, okay, so it's like a light spell that doesn't work immediately. Oh, interesting. They actually have like little tiny levers. Weird. Hey, Dirge, how's it going? We're in a Darkfall passage right now, heading towards Oriole's bow. Yes, it's a concentration spell, so I guess you hold out your hand the whole time and then they like lose health per second. I'll test it out.
on the next thing that we see. Okay. Anything back here? Yep, there's a skeleton. With a satchel. We'll take the ultimate healing. And that stuff too. Okay, there's some sort of weird ass saber cat. Nice, nice dirge. The Veil Saber Cat. Oh gosh, it got stuck in animation. Veil Saber Cat. The awkward moment when you kill something. But it stills the animation to continue. Poison bloom added. Did you just... Oh, you raised that skeleton back there. I was like, what the hell? Oh, they got those nice black reach mushrooms going on. Gotta like those. I'm kind of stuck on a rock right now. There we go. Give me that stuff. We got these weird... I think they poison you? Yeah, they do poison you a little bit, but I keep absorbing it, which is kind of cool.
Never saw anything like this, but
and I keep coughing because of it. Ooh, there's like veil deer. Oh, that's cool. There we go. Got him. I need these shiny pelts. Veil deer hide. Nice. I know, right, Sabriel? I friggin' know. Maybe I'm the Dragonborn and I don't know it yet. No, you're not. Alright, so it looks like you have to harvest them before they sort of open up or else they poison you. Is there anything in the water? There's gotta be something in the water here. Right? Water treasure? Water secrets? Damn it. Every time I think there's a water secret, there's no water secret. Friggin' it. Oops. I was so distracted by the beautiful scenery, I just fell straight into the water. Gotta take the blossom before the... There we go. Otherwise, I start coughing. That is a less Veil Spirit Cat, or like a Spirit Veil Spirit Cat. Spirit Cat Cat. It's a double cat. It also had an amethyst on it. Alright, let's see. Alright, I think we're getting somewhere now. Or they blow poison on me. There we go, nice. Don't know what those are used for. But I'm sure alchemy is you know, a thing for that. Here we go.
Welcome, initiate. This is the Way Shrine of Illumination. Are you prepared to honor the mantras of Ariel and fill your vessel with his enlightenment?
You're gonna get unlimited storage first. For which one, Airborne? Yes, I'm ready.
Then behold Ariel's gift, my child. May it light your path as you seek tranquility within the inner sanctum.
Oh, fall. Interesting.
May Ariel's brilliance illuminate your path.
Okay. Filled the ewer. I guess let's continue then. Give me all these flowers. I need all of them.
May Ariel's brilliance illuminate your path.
I mean, I may not need all of them, but still. Actually, what did they do out of curiosity for alchemy? Man, we got 9 Danger Hearts. That's awesome. Here is the Gleam Blossom. Resist Magic, that's a nice one. And Poison Bloom. Damage Health. Who would have guessed? Who would have guessed? Alright, to the Forgotten Veil. The mod that lets you be a hoarder. Yep. Yep. It's gonna be weird because I think in survival mode they lessen the amount of stuff that you can carry, like, significantly. So it's gonna be pretty weird for me because I usually play a very horror-esque character. Interesting. There's definitely like a way to get back to here from like an upper cave. Although I just made myself dizzy by looking at that ceiling, but that's okay. Oh, hey, this is the cave I was talking about. Yeah, yeah, I've played Borderlands 1 and Borderlands 2. Yep. Had a great time with both of them, actually. Really enjoyed Borderlands 2, played a lot of it. Although, I have to say, I didn't end up... Oh, you know what happened is I ruined Borderlands 2 for myself. What I did was, I got Borderlands 2 when it came out, and basically I was waiting for DLC, and so what I did was I'm like, alright, well I'll just level myself up to, I haven't played Borderlands with mods, that sounds awesome. But yeah, I was waiting for mods to come out, and basically what happened was I went ahead and, like, basically fought the last boss, like, over and over and over again until I was level 40. And then basically what ended up happening was I had guns that, like, melted everything. Like, absolutely everything. So I would do a DLC and I would get no good weapons because all good weapons I had were from previous, like, numerous boss battles I had. That'd be interesting to consider. I didn't realize there was, like, a modding thing for, Borderlands 2. Or the Borderlands series in general. I might have to look into that. I don't need deer venison. And I didn't put away my soul husk for some reason. Yeah, it sounds interesting. Yeah, probably my favorite weapon that I ever got in that series was I have a Malawan submachine gun poison. Yeah, poison Malawan submachine gun. It was pretty damn awesome. I know there's like special like legendaries and named stuff in this series, but that was just one of my favorite weapons. I like using elemental weapons because they're badass. Spirit animal blossom. Kind's pleased. Take all those. Saber cat eye, I'll take. And all the veil stuff. There is. Oh, okay, you reanimated it here. That's kind of disturbing. They actually have goat eyes.
Let's get indoors. Or in a cave.
That's weird.
Anywhere, just out of this.
They have goat eyes, man. Deer with goat eyes. That can't be healthy. Alrighty. This place is pretty massive, actually. So we have to fill up the pitcher with a couple different things, don't we? See if we can't drop through the ice at all. Alright, let's see. Let's go up this way first. Sort of just explore the edges. With our veil deer summon. Not really summoned. Bethesda, did you hide secrets up here? Little secrets on cliffs? Ah, you did hide silver ore. I'll take it, I guess. At this point, I don't actually think I need it, but I'll still take it. Hey, more silver ore. Nice. I still don't think I have the perks required to actually smith jewelry. Hey, kitty cat for sleep. How's it going? We're in the inner veil right now, looking for Oriole's bow. We're going through an initiation process. And, you know, of course, what do? You kill anything that is, you know, shiny. So, that's what we're doing. We're killing shiny things. Oh gosh, we just killed a cub. Welcome to the stream. We kill cubs, apparently. Take some gold ore. Excellent. Yeah, I'm doing good, doing good. Let's see. So we went up that mountain, but oh gosh, what the hell? There's a whole bunch of spiders. That one quite didn't connect there. What level am I? I'm gonna have to check. I think I'm 53, 54, somewhere around there. 54 sort of led to here, so I wanna check out this, like, first area, I guess, before we sort of venture out. So I don't wanna go too far out. And then I have to be like, okay, we have to go all the way back for, like, this thing that was, like, just... Yeah, we have one legendary skill that we're... Actually, we have one legendary skill that I haven't really put anything into. And I'm probably going to make legendary again. Heavy weaponry just goes up so quickly for some reason. It's ridiculous. My enchanting's all the way maxed. We've got basically everything I'd want with smithing. Although... if I had extra perk points, I would maybe start going into this, because apparently I can have Dwarven Constructs following me around, which would be friggin' sweet. But I haven't really gotten into that yet. But we have max enchanting, which is awesome. So basically everything we have is you know, fantastically enchanted, which is great. So I that cliff sort of led to here, so I want to check out this, like, first area, I guess, before we sort of venture out. So I don't want to go too far out. And then I have to be like, okay, we have to go all the way back for, like, this thing that was, like, just sitting here. Give me those green blossoms. Looks like... is that a Falmer? It's a Falmer. There we go. Sweet. We've got a cave here. We've got something that's actually seems very close. So let's see if we can't grab another cistern or whatever it's called. Oh, yep, yeah, we got one right here. Nice. And we've got a spirit deer. Nice. Kine is pleased. How pleased is Kine? Let me see. This is from the Thunder Child mod, which adds a ton of new shouts, basically being able to rearrange the words. And pleasing Kine, or basically the, you know, god of nature, is one of the things you have to do. 67% out of 200%. That's pretty good. Sweet. That should help. Silver ore. I think we can ignore the silver ore for now, but I will take these flowers, because it's the only place you see these flowers. And who knows when I might need them. Oh yeah, I need to shout the sky for Kine. You're absolutely right. I don't know. I guess the sky here would count, right? Alright, let's Fusroda the sky.
Fusroda!
Well, that one didn't count, apparently. Let me try that again.
Fusroda!
No. I guess maybe we're in a cave, technically? I don't know. But yeah, normally shouting at the sky is something that improves Kine's thing. Like, basically, we have repeatable quests for Kine. Let's see, where is it? Champion of Kine. We can donate gold to Arngir, shout to the heavens once a day, hunt Kine spirit animals, which is what we keep doing, gain the voice of the sky's blessing. I don't even know what that means. We can touch, and this is like stuff that you do that, like, I don't know, does some interesting stuff. I haven't carried Kine's fire to the doors of High Hrothgar, which we can do eventually. I tried it once and didn't quite make it all the way, because I think it acts as like a mini game, I'm pretty sure. Like, you're not supposed to be able to draw weapons and stuff like that, and like run up all the way to the tower. It's kind of weird.
Welcome, initiate. This is the Way Shrine of Sight.
Okay.
Are you prepared to honor the mantras of Ariel and fill your vessel with his enlightenment?
Yes.
Then behold Ariel's gift, my child. May it speed your journey to the inner sanctum.
I'm no fan of the sun, but it would be better than this.
Well, hi, sir. Alright, fill the basin. Sweet. And that's to Darkfall Passage. So I guess that's the way we go back then. Alright, good to know. And it looks like there's a few caves and another above ground one, but I'm not sure if it's this close. Let me check the map here. Yeah, I don't think it is. Darkfall Passage. Forgotten Vale Cave. Alright, let's check out the middle here before we head up. We'll probably go to the cave first, just to see what it's like. go to the cave then. Kine was not pleased. Kine was like, shut the hell up. Stop shouting. Alright, Forgotten Vale Cave, let's do this. Oh, it's one of those weird Charis warriors. Oh gosh, why? It's a weird abomination created by the Immersive Creatures mod. Stop it. Stop being a horrible creature. Charis Grim Warrior. Take the chitin, the antennae, and that. Alrighty. And whatever chitin you have as well. Yay! Oh no, I'm over encumbered, but it's okay. I've got deep storage. Might as well highlight it. Deep storage, yay! Is there a way that I can organize this? Oh, okay. We use inside voices when we're in caves. Deep storage, hell yeah. Best spell I ever bought. Yeah, best spell I ever bought. I mean, technically you could argue that Long Stride's also really nice. But this basically makes it so that I no longer... Oh, I could put the drawn F away, nice. I no longer have to actually... basically have a companion anymore, which is... You know, one of the things that's... It's not something that bothers me, but it's like one of those things, like, the only reason I really bring companions around is so I have someone else to blame. That's one thing. But it also allows me to be like, okay, so I have, like, another, like, 500 pounds of shit I need you to carry. And the soul husks, which apparently didn't weigh anything. And I'll put these away as well. At least everything but the Danger Hearts, because I like keeping the Danger Hearts on me. Ah, crap, whatever, I put it away. Deep storage, give me those Danger Hearts back. That helps. Plus, I think Serana's in a weird, like, follower mode. She's not in the amazing follower tweaks follower mode. She's in like the normal vanilla follower mode, which is weird sometimes. So I'm just not gonna try to access her inventory at all. Oh, I'm gonna go in here and I'm gonna go full blast actually. First, lightning shield. Then this. Is there actually anybody in here? Yeah, there is. Is that thing dead? Nope, it is. It's dead. That thing's alive still. Hey, my heavy armor increased. That's cool. Did he die? I think I keep, like, making them fall into the hole. Alright, we're good now. I hear some weird clicking and clacking, which isn't the best. Alright, I think I got it. Press that lever. Oh my gosh, I forgot about this thing. It's a shell bug.
So, you can mine shell bugs. Shell bugs basically act as a mine, and I think you kill them when you do this. But it's like a live creature. Alright, let's do it. Shell bug chitin. Yep, this shell bug is dead. Yep, it kills it. You basically like strip it of its chitin. Oh boy. Are we terrible people? Maybe. But we got shell bug chitin. It's all covered in blood, holy crap. Oh man. Yep, that's all of its chitin on that side gone. I think that's how it's supposed to happen. I think actually the shell bug helmet is actually really, really has some decent armor on it, if I'm not mistaken. I have to check out what else we can make with it. That's more sad than you thought it would be. Yeah. Yeah, I know. I don't like doing it. I don't like doing it either. Because it doesn't try to hurt you or anything. It's just being a bug in a cave. It's not doing anything. It's probably terrified of you. And there you are just like ripping its shell off while it's still alive with a pickaxe. It's pretty horrible. Pretty horrible. It's kind of like, I don't know, trying to eat a lobster or crab while it's still alive. Being like, I'm going to take this and leave. Cool with that. I'm going to check something here. I doubt they have that, but in the complete crafting overhaul, do they have a thing about mining shell bugs that makes it less depressing? Mining and materials. Ingot production, nope, firewood, expert activation. Yeah, it'd be like someone came up to you and, yeah, started peeling your skin off with a fork. Yeah, about, basically, yeah. Yeah. What does that do? Allows you to adjust the strength of tampering improvements on effects. Okay, interesting. Huh. Oh well, there doesn't seem to be a menu to have like the non-depressing version of mining a shell bug, which would be to just wait for it to molt, as opposed to ripping its, you know, chitin off. But you know, I guess we're too impatient for, you know, waiting for that to happen, so we just go ahead and rip its chitin off. Oh yeah! Aren't there crazy, like, giant mountain trolls in this area? I think there are. Coin purse, unknown volume 1. Bring ancient Falmer tome. Oh, to the dude! Black Mammoth recurve bow, nice. Oh, does the skeleton have anything? For a second, I thought the skeleton came back to life and it was like in full dragon armor, and I was really freaking scared. Oh, there's another one over here. Alright, sweet. We got another one.
You've reached the Way Shrine of Learning, Initiate. Are you prepared to honor the mantras of Ariel and fill your vessel with his enlightenment?
Yes.
Ariel bless you, child, for you are a step closer to the inner sanctum and everlasting wisdom.
I love that all you have to do is have, like, the pitcher and, like, be able to say yes, and apparently that's the ritual, because they just basically have, like, essentially what are, like, robots. Alright, we'll fill this up. Sweet. 3 out of 5.
May Ariel's warmth imbue your body with strength.
Alright, I think I'm actually going to stop there for the day, and we'll continue exploring this gigantic freaking area tomorrow. So yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed. We'll be back to fill up my pitcher of water, which is actually, it's pretty like a crazy looking pitcher of water. I mean, you'd hurt someone, right? If you were in a bar fight, like you hold that up like that, and you friggin' just, and you hit him with the spiky side. I mean, friggin' A, that's a bitchin' pitcher. Holy crap. But yeah, so I hope you guys enjoyed. And yeah, we'll fill up that pitcher with water, and we'll try to get Oriole's bow tomorrow then. So yeah, hope you guys enjoyed, and I'll see you next time. Alright, see ya!